Okay, so you're welcome. Today we have in our studios Mr. Atakwa Meniamponyameche, and he is going to talk to us about Reality Ghana. He's the CEO of Reality Ghana. So we'll go straight to him and he will tell us more about Reality Ghana.
Thank you for having me in your studios.
You're welcome.
It's a beautiful story how it all started. The little politician and me started our contested to be the assembly man of my electoral area, somewhere at a center called Kusa electoral area. And good news or bad news, I lost the elections. I became second and I was next to the incumbent. And so I was pondering over the stuff I wanted to do for the community. I believe leadership is about serving, not about what you're going to gain. So I was pondering about the ideas I wanted for my electoral area, building up community library for the kids to learn, taking care of the less privileged, among others. So I was discussing with two of my friends way back on campus, they call us the three idiots. Salasi and Apoti.
University or?
University. Okay. So Salasi and Apoti, I was like, okay, ATK. They call me ATK. It's a good story. Let's invite people out there who are also sharing the same vision and let's see what we can do together. And so we started inviting professionals from all walks of life, the police, the military, the teachers, the politicians, what have you, and then to come and build Reality Ghana. Actually, so now it's now made up of professionals of diverse backgrounds. You can get everybody in Reality Ghana. You can get all the, professionals in Reality Ghana. And then the vision or the mission is simple. Let's go out there and make the world a better place than we found it. Our activities span around supporting the less privileged, volunteering, creating health awareness in communities and churches alike. And we also want to get ourselves actively involved in national dispensations and stuff like that. We are a year and some months older, and then it's doing beautifully. We so much into beautiful stuff, and then we've done a lot of beautiful stuff. So in a nutshell, that's what Reality Ghana is about. Okay. When you meet a realist and they say Reality Ghana, the slogan is going to be like, dare to drink.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. You have said a lot, but I want to know, what motivated you to choose the name Reality Ghana?
Okay. What is reality? Reality is that a kid in the street should be given a home. Reality is that an orphan somewhere in the orphanage home should be taken care of. Reality is that you have to volunteer and then build your nation. That is reality. So if these are the realities of our life, why don't we hammer on it? You know, let's do the real things. Let's create awareness of the youth. The real things we have to do are the things we are ignoring. Like the street children, the little we can help get them off the streets, like the orphans, like the poor, the less privileged in the villages, we can reach out to them and then do stuff with them. I mean, help them. So reality is you helping a brother in need. Reality is you telling the politician that this policy can be shaped this way to affect us positively. So reality is that thing which is real in this time. So that's why we chose the name Reality Ghana.
It's beautiful, I like it. And so I would like to know, today it's about we having a conversation, and I just want to know, since you started, it's been like a year now.
Yeah.
Have you been able to do something for a community that's
okay,
for less privileged children or for...
All right, we've been able to do quite a lot. When I sit back and I look at the stuff we did in 2016, I was like, ooh, we can even do more. You know, we went to for a start. We started our outreach programs at Marina. We did a very mass cleanup exercise in the community of Madina, because we believe that next to godliness is cleanliness, you know. And then that is where we started from. So a very, very large scale cleanup exercise was happening in Madina. And then from there we went to a village in the central region called Agunofwansi.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's a place that when you give somebody 5 CD as a gift, it takes the whole family to come out there to come say thank you to you. So you can imagine, I did my service there.
That is reality.
I did my service there about 5 years ago. So I saw the plight of the people there. I was like, we can do something. And good news is that when I saw the idea to my people, they bought into the idea. And so we went there to the village. We distributed about 4,500 pieces of clothes to the whole villages. Surrounding villages then came around to that same town, that same village, and then we distributed it. We awarded scholarship to 5 brilliant Ghanaian students. We established Reality Ghana's library in the village.
Wow.
With a startup book of about 2,000 worth of reading materials, which will be feeding in every month. And a lot of stuff happening in Ofumasi. That is just like that. And then I also mentioned that we involved in national dispensation issues. So November we organized a big peace walk towards the election that was held in December 2016 to sink down the message to the politician that the youth are not only architects for political violence and chaos, but we can also be used for architects for peace and nation building. So we sent that message out loud. The work was from La Paz to Dansoma Kipis, that quite a long journey, but with the spirit and the love of the country, we went that far. And then in December we visited the Fishing Orphanage home. December was 30th was actually for our dinner. And then realists were like, no, ATK, we are not going to have a dinner whilst some people out there are not having a dinner. So pick a call, and then we have to organize something, and then we have to go there and give them their dinner before we can have our dinner in the evening. And so these are some of the stuffs we did last year. And then this year the programs are already packed and it's going to be so beautiful.
Wow, that's a beautiful story he has just shared with us. If I ask you to describe your marketing strategy in 3 words, what would you say?
Marketing strategy. So, what we do? What we do is that we find a niche.
Okay.
A niche or a market that nobody is serving.
Finding
a marketing where nobody is serving, actually. Like in 2017, some of our programs is to reach out to the younger ones in the secondary schools. We call it Felicity and the school's missions.
Okay.
Understand? So that's going to be a big selling point. Go out there and tell the kids. You know, some people complete secondary school, they don't even know the course they're going to do. Some people end up doing dendrology and stuff like that just because they're going to the University of Ghana.
Yeah.
And we believe that with a series of seminars set up in basic secondary schools, you can go out there and tell them what it is in the real world after secondary school. So
yeah,
we found a niche, and then we also use the new developing trend. Social media is very much active now, so we use that point to push our message out there or to get people to know about that stuff.
So they find a niche and then they help people. I mean, they push their job,
the new trends,
exactly, out there for other people. The next question is that, what excites you about this job? Because for what I know, you don't really get much from it, as in much income to yourself. So what excites you and what makes you want to go on and do it?
Okay, my father once told me something, that the beauty of the world is not how happy you are, but how happy others are because of you. You know, for me, it's the satisfaction I derive from all of this is that, like, we went to Ofumasi, you are back home, and then you're thinking that, okay, so somebody's going to be happy because of what you went there to go do, because of what we're going to went there to go do. So the excitement, knowing that somebody's going to smile because of that little thing you gave him or her, is what pushes me every day, every time. Knowing that you are solving a need, knowing that you are bringing smiles to people's faces, is what's really exciting about reality. I mean, about this job of philanthropy, orphanages stuff or NGO stuff.
So, if you are a young business entrepreneur and you want to start business, do you need an office? I mean, what do you need to start your own business?
Okay, well, most often the question is like, how much do you need to start a business? In these days, but I think the question is not how much, it's who do you know or who knows you actually. So like I started with the story of Reality Ghana. I knew 2 people plus me making the 3 idiots, you know, and then these people connected us to people, you understand? So we didn't even actually need a physical office, but we made use of social media, what it is now called virtual office. And then we run in Reality Ghana. We just about the process of getting a physical office. But even now, with all the achievements and all what we are doing, we don't have a physical office.
Okay.
We have a virtual office.
Okay.
And so, you know, you don't need the how much, but you need the who. You understand? Like, Reality Ghana is set up in such a way that everybody who comes on board knows what he's coming to do. So, they come on board knowing that I'm going to play a part of this story. I'm going to contribute to make sure that this happens. So, you don't really need the how much, but you need the who. In his name.
So you don't need how much, you need who. I mean, you need people who are dedicated to help you start your own business. Let's look at how your calendar for the year looks like.
Okay, so at our AGM held about 3 weeks ago, we broke the year into quarters, like first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, last quarter. In the first quarter, we're looking at, in February, we're doing a free health screening.
So how many months is in a quarter?
How many months? It's three. Three in a quarter. So the first quarter, we're doing a free health screening for the aged and blood donation at Adenta, 50 years and above. That is for February. And then we also be running the school, the Relative Ghana Schools missions.
Yeah, sure.
Within the first quarter and probably beyond. And then the next program for us in the first quarter is what we call the Ada Village Outreach. We'll be staying a weekend at Ada. We'll be having interaction with the folks in the town. We'll be donating clothes to them. We'll be playing fanful football where they'll be talking to the chiefs and opinion leaders and all those that matter in the area to ensure that livelihood is empowered, to ensure that our health people are there to talk to them about health awareness, how to avoid certain kind of diseases and stuff. So we're going to go down to the folks in Ada, interact with them, donate to them, make friends with them, and then we have some fun time with them. So that is it for the first quarter. And the second quarter, we're looking at doing all the programs in Kumasi. Reality is, everywhere in Ghana, we have people who are even outside of the country, we have members of Reality Ghana. So in Kumasi, we'll be doing a visit to a prison. You know, the prison story is always told that people are criminals out there, but not all of them are really that, yeah, but you see. Sure. So we'll be going out there to do the little we can to make the conditions in the prison better for them. We'll be organizing a cleanup exercise in Kumasi as well, and we'll be also embarking on the membership float.
Okay.
You know, with our flyers going around, inviting people who want to be part of this fishing, be part of this dream, to join the family. So that is for the second quarter. And then the third quarter, we are doing a very interesting exercise. And, maybe I'll invite you over if your superiors will allow that. We're doing charity car wash. It's interesting. You're going to see these beautiful ladies.
Yes, I'll be watching one of them.
Beautiful people holding stuff, screening cars, car screens, and major traffic lights in the community to, in the city to raise funds for our next project in the third quarter, which happens to be Meals on Pills. Understand? So Meals on Wheels is basically about feeding the street kids. You know, we wish we can do Meals on Wheels, you understand? So we're going to cook the meals, as many bags of rice as we can, as many as all the foods as we can. And then we go with our wheels. So every street kid we find in the streets of Accra, we'll be doing it. We just feed the person. And then this is going to be a yearly program. Meals on Wheels is going to be a yearly program. So this year we're running out Meals on Wheels. For the last quarter, we of course do our donation, and then we will not go by the year or let the year end without our dinner. So we also have our Reality Ghana dinner stroke the awards. And so that's how our year build up is formally. But in between time, you know, we receive some proposals from some schools or from some villages, and then we do squeeze them in. So these plans are not cast in stones. They are flexible enough for us to accommodate other proposals from other people who may need our help. So that's how our year build up looks like for Reality Ghana.
Thank you.
Is there any reason why
you just know if you have any plans going to the northern region, the northern part of Ghana?
Okay, Reality Ghana is Ghana. What we do is that, you know, we're going to Kumasi for the Kumasi float to establish the Kumasi chapter of Reality Ghana.
Okay.
So someday, very soon, we'll also be reaching out to the northern people. So we establish Reality Ghana, northern regional chapter.
Okay.
You understand? So once the chapter is there, we don't even have to travel ourselves from Accra to go north. But the chapter in North will do basically exactly what we're doing to impact lives here and also. So every region we're taking care of, not only the North, but specifically, I mean, all the regions in Ghana. So the North it will also be taken care of very, very soon.
Okay.
Yeah.
So with all the projects that you do, you need money.
Yeah.
How do you get your funds?
For now, we organize our funds inwardly. Inwardly means members of Reality Ghana contribute towards that cause.
Wow, then you guys have a ritual.
We are blessed. We are blessed.
Yes.
We are blessed to know we have to give out to receive more. You know, it's a natural rule of nature. You give, you get. You give, you get. So you don't have to be rich before you go out there to reach on somebody. If you have 2 cedis, you give a person 1 cedi. Naturally, in no time, you see you have it. You have it back, baby. You have it quantified. You understand?
Okay.
So, like I said, we have quite a peculiar way of recruiting people to join the family. You know, we ask you whether you can do this. And you say yes. If you say yes, then you are joined. If you say no, then you can't push our vision with us, you understand? So when it comes up, like the health screening happening in February 18th. Okay, this is the budget. Who can help with that? Somebody will say, okay, if the budget is, let's say, 2,000, I want to help with 1,000. Somebody will say, I want to help 200, someone will say, and then it's done.
Cool.
So that is how it is. That's how we roll out. But we're looking at getting, grants from elsewhere. But until then, we roll with our pocket.
That is beautiful.
Yeah.
So we are live on Behind the Sparkles, and we have here the CEO of Reality Ghana. My name is Maame and Asantewaa, and I'm your host. I'll be asking him one question. If he had the chance to be president for 100 days, what would he do for our country?
Then he also called me His Excellency at the Premier and Ponya.
Yes, His Excellency.
Well, what will I do within the first 100 days?
Yes. Will you call ministers?
I will use the first probably 40 days to name all those people, they go through vetting. But what I'll tackle first within my first 100 days is to rid Ghana of debt. You know, it's quite an eyesore to know that in the 21st century, Ghana, which will be 60 years from some days from now, does experience cholera in its name. What I will do within my first 100 days as a priority is to clean the cities. Clean the cities of filth. So, aside from naming people as my
ministers
and the regional. Okay, let's see about that. So that's what I'll do. I'll read the cities of filth and ensure that it is free of filth and free of cholera. It was unspeakable to know that Ghana,
exactly,
60 years down the lane, is still talking about cholera.
Disease. Anyway, thank you so much for being on today's show. It was wonderful having you around. I wish I can ask you more questions. I actually want to ask more questions, but then we will not be permitted to do that. So behind scenes, I'll ask you all the questions that I need to know and then post them on our social media pages. So you can visit Behind the Sparkles on Facebook. You can also visit us Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat at BTS_show. And my name is Maame Asantewaa. It was wonderful having you here on today's episode. Thank you for being here and thank you for watching. Thank you for coming as well.
My pleasure,
sir. What's the
name? Alright, my name is Atakwa Benyam Ponya Meche, CEO of Reality Ghana. I really enjoyed my time with Maame Asantewaa on the Behind the Sparkle show. And then it was a great time as she was throwing professional questions on Reality Ghana. And so let me seize the opportunity to tell you watching out there what Reality Ghana is about. It's a beautiful group made up of people from diverse professional backgrounds who seek in a nutshell to make the world a better place than we find it. Our activities span around providing care and support for the less privileged, creating health awareness in communities and churches alike, volunteering, active involvement in national dispensation, and then in a nutshell, we do all these things to create smiles or to make the world a beautiful place. If you're wondering how you can become a member of Reality Ghana, just like our Facebook page, Reality Ghana, leave a message there, the admins will pick your contacts and then they will take you through the vetting process. You know, you don't just join Reality Ghana, you go through the vetting. We sell to you our vision, we sell to you our objectives, we sell to you our rules. So if you believe that you're going to abide by all this, if you believe you're going to play active involvement to help us push our dream out there, then you are welcome on board. So basically, this is what you have to do. Leave a message on our WhatsApp page or our Facebook page, Reality Ghana. Or you can also get in touch or to one of the administrators on this number, 05433-64484. Come join beautiful people, do beautiful things to ensure that the world is better than we found it. Reality Ghana, you dare to dream. Thank you.